Hey guys, Paisteboy here. Today we're going to be doing an install of some APS iBoard running boards on my 2019 Chevy Silverado. If you have a truck of this era, which began in 2019 and should be current through 21 as far as I know, this should work for you. If you have a little bit older Chevy or GMC, I do have a couple other videos, one from a 2017 Chevy Silverado and one from a 2012 Chevy Silverado. I'll put a card up there if those are more the model you have. But today we're also going to be doing a giveaway of a set of iBoard running boards. So stick around and let's get this job done. So here's a before shot from the driver's side. Just a quick look at what the truck looks like before we put the running boards on. Got my brother Mark here. He's gonna help me. And today we're gonna be putting on these running boards. These are slightly different than the ones that I've done in the other two videos. I just wanted something a little different this time. So let's get this box put down and I'll show you what we got. All right, so I'm going to give you a quick shot of what these new ones look like. These are a little different than the other two sets, like I said. I wanted something a little bit different. This kind of has like a step with a back on it. So if you are worried about slipping or anything, you've got a little toe hold here, which that's one of the things that I really liked about these. And I thought they were completely solid, but they're hollow underneath, so they're gonna be lighter. And it's all extruded aluminum, so I really don't have a problem with that at all. These look really well made. The only downside is it's not, you know, the other ones, they had no cap. It was just solid extruded, and these, they had to put a little cap, but that doesn't really bother me too much. I think they look really sharp. So let's get started taking a look at the directions and the hardware, right?
Yep.
All right, let's take a look at what's in the hardware bag. So we got a slew of screws,
those
square
are
headed, and then here we have standard bolts, washers, and nuts. Okay, so the little nylon locking nuts go with these square headed bolts. And we'll illustrate that obviously in this install. We'll show you the directions real quick. Yeah. My brother got a set of these as well. He got the ones like I had on my 2017, which are great, but I just wanted a little change. So here he goes, couple pages. Here's the back. If you need to look at that quickly, you know, just wanted you to see it. And these are the directions, and we're gonna follow them as much as we need to, but we're pretty familiar with them at this point. So what do you say we get started?
Yeah, it should be pretty easy.
All right. So here we're looking at the driver's side underneath. We've got it up on the lift. Just want to show you what that looks like before we get too far. So we need to put a mount near the front end, one just before the back of the driver door, and then another one at the far rear. And I'll show you what that looks like from under here. So where are we putting this first one, Mark?
Right here.
Okay.
And then in the middle.
In the middle.
And then all the way at the back.
And then far back. So we have to pull those plugs.
Yep.
And we'll show you that as we get to it. And then we will attach the hardware so that we can mount the bracket to the frame. So we'll be pulling, let's see if I can point to it, the little cap that should already have the thread to bolt these two installed on the frame. Where on the older models, you had to pull the big plug to slip a mount in. So Mark's gonna pop the little plug off and expose that. It's already got the threading, so you don't need any of the clips.
Awesome.
Yeah, this will be even faster.
Yep.
With the newer body style. And obviously APS already knew that. So why don't we, so Mark will pull all of those. And there's the second one. There's the first two. one on top, one on the side. And then right behind the door, let me just verify that those are the two from this side. Is there one slightly further back here?
That's way back here.
Okay, then it's definitely that one. So it'd be that far behind the driver door where the other two plugs are that you're gonna remove. Because you need that good firm support right there where you're actually stepping to get into the vehicle. And then the third set will be back there, that close to the back side of the rear door. And of course, this is the double cab. You'll never need those again.
Nope.
The three brackets that are the same go on the driver's side. Doesn't matter which one you put where.
So bolt, lock washer, washer into the truck. So this is gonna go right there. All right,
yep.
Let me get the bolts ready. All right, so you got your bolt, then your lock washer, then your flat washer.
Right, so all these right. are the bigger of all the hardware.
Yep.
Okay.
So then, step this up here, over there. That's that. Let me put the other one, then I'll get my air ratchet.
Yeah, I think on the other ones, we were mounting the brackets to the running boards and then installing the, right, didn't we? Because when you're underneath, it's hard to mount the running boards to the brackets, but you know, if you're laying on the ground, but
yeah.
when you're in the air like this, it's easier to just put the brackets on the truck itself first. And you know, it's not like the truck's touching the ground, so you'd be able to do it the other way as well.
I gotta get a pick. There's like rubber seal in there.
Okay.
And it's not going.
Yeah, we're just gonna clean that out real quick. So just showing you real quick before we screw them in all the way tight. We got the second bolt on the bottom in. There was a little bit of that rubber sealer in there, so Mark just pulled it out with a pick and it's clean and threaded right in. And another thing I'm noticing compared to the older truck model ones, now they may have updated this on the older brackets, but the ones I had when I did the last video, they were flat black painted. These appear to be black powder coated, so they're gonna inhibit the rust a lot longer. So we'll continue and pick this back up as after we get all three of the brackets installed on the driver's side. Action! Obviously, you'll be doing these by hand, so use your best judgment on how tight. I'm not sure if there's any torque specs on the paperwork. If there are, follow that. All right, one down and two to go. Just wanted to point out that the orientation of the brackets, because they'll only go on one side properly. All right, so Mark was looking over the brackets, and it looks like there is no oddball bracket for this this model. So if you have a 2019 or newer Chevy or GMC, the bracketry is all the same, three for the left and three for the right side. This is the rear passenger side. Finish it up by hand.
Yeah, because I can't get in with the air ratchet.
Yeah. There's a little wraparound lip on the bottom of that bracket. Now this is specific possibly to this particular iBoard, so. That's the middle bracket near the rear of the passenger front door. There we go. Last bracket.
I don't know why. The frame is closer or something on this?
There's less clearance on the passenger side. Take a look at the driver's side. Yeah, there is more space on this side.
That's weird.
Yeah.
that's that, and now we'll put the beams on.
So here's the three brackets from the outside on the passenger side. Looking good. So we're about to install these. It's pretty, they've got this system down great between GMC and Chevy, putting the threading already in there. And then these brackets are just going in like a piece of cake. Really straightforward. As you can see, we're here on the passenger side, and that board is tipped up on its side, so like this. And you have these two rails. You're going to slip the six square-headed bolts into these channels. You know, they don't have to be exactly where you need them just yet, because we're going to set these right on top of the brackets here.
Show it over here.
Yeah, so. Slide that right in. There you go. So there's the two for the rear end, got the two for the middle, and the two for the front end. Okay, so we're gonna set it in here. And then we'll get the bolts all lined up, one set at a time. So as you can see here, the two bolts, and that's, you know, that can slide, so you could pull them out, pull it out further, or push it in further, depending on how you want yours set. There's the middle set. Now, of course, here we are on the passenger side, just letting you know, for your orientation. But it will be identical on the other side. So we've got the six bolts.
They can also, you can bring them in and out a little bit if
yep,
you want to.
That's what
too,
I was just saying.
I don't know. I feel more comfortable at just being up against it.
Yeah, let me get a higher view and see what it looks like, because if they're tucked in too far, then you lose too much of the step. Personally, I liked it pulled out all the way, because it's still, it's going to give you the maximum amount of step. And of course, these can also always be adjusted. So what I'm saying is, if you feel like there's too much flex on it, loosen them up, push them in, and tighten them back down. And that will give it a little more rigidity, but I'm going to try them out fully pulled out, because I want the maximum step. And you can see where the back of the vertical portion is. It's still behind the bottom of the rocker. So we're good with that. We're going to tighten them up, do the same thing on the other side, and wrap this up. The one thing I just want to mention real quick, if you are going to install them pulled out, they do stick out wider than the wheel base.
Maybe by like an inch.
About an inch, yeah. So keep that in mind, going through narrow spaces, car washes, whatever. I'm gonna keep that in mind myself in case we just push them back in. All right, so you put your washer on, and then your nylon locking nut, which is a 10 millimeter. This is the rear end of the passenger side, if you can't tell. So we're just gonna get them finger tight for now. And so we'll attach all six nuts and washers in this orientation, and then begin to tighten them down. Crucial that you get the washers, because you won't have enough surface area there to adequately hold them without the washers.
Start tightening in the back?
Yes. And so for the inner one, we're going to use a swivel on the ratchet. You can see that there. But otherwise, you'll have to use a box wrench.
I'm going to do the outside ones, and then we'll get the insides. So this should get tight enough. If not, we'll just grab a wrench. Oh yeah, definitely tight enough. Okay, well, that works. All right, one side done.
All right, we'll do the other side and then we'll pull her out. And it's identical, so I'm not gonna bother filming that side, but we'll get that side done and then we'll pull the truck out and get a good look at her.
Sweet.
We'll get a better look at it when we get back home. This is the final result. I think they look sharp. I love how it's kind of set in, you know, so you've got like a little pocket there in case, you know, if you were, your foot was to slip, it'll hit. And they go the full length. You know, it looks like it, the truck is actually lower to the ground now because of that, but it's just gonna make things a little easier. You know, not that it's hard to get into a truck, obviously, but it's nice having that little step. Let's go around to the other side and take a look. And there we have it, looking sharp. I want to thank APS for sponsoring this video. All right, here's the final reveal. Just got her washed. And as you can see, not an issue. I love it, the way they're the sticking out like that. Like if you don't like that little bit of gap, you can just, like I said, push them all the way in. To enter to win a set of these iBoards, leave a comment below with the word win in your comment and you will be automatically entered. If you're interested in checking these iBoards in, check the links in the description and you could also purchase them there. The contest will end December 31st, 2020, so enter before then. I will draw one random winner after that and contact you through your YouTube page. And we'll give you further details at that point. Well, thanks for watching. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you like my content, please subscribe if you haven't already. Leave a comment below if this video helped you. Check the links in the description. Go like me, Paisteboy, on Facebook and Instagram. And we'll see you next time. Take care.